बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलामुअलैकुम स्टूडेंट्स। नाउ वी हैव आर प्रैक्टिस क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम आर टेक्स्ट बुक पेज नंबर 256। वी हैव अ क्वेश्चन नंबर 1। ए बी एंड सी डी आर स्ट्रेट लाइंस। वी हैव ए बी एंड सी डी, दीज टू वी हैव स्ट्रेट लाइंस। फाइंड angle P and angle Q. Angle P and angle Q we are going to find out. Angle P and 120 degree, these two we have vertically opposite angles, so these two are same. So angle P is equal to 120 degree. The reason is vertically opposite angle. Now we have angle Q. As we know that AB is a straight line, AB is a straight line, and these two angles lie on a straight line. We know that angle on a straight line add up to 180 degree. It means angle Q plus 120 degree, we have 180 degree, because angle on a straight line add up to 180 degree. Now if we want to find out angle Q, we subtract 120 from 180 degree. Now we get 60 degree. So easily we find that angle Q is equal to 60 degree. Now we have question number 2. AB and CD are straight lines. AB and CD are straight lines. Find angle X, angle Y and angle Z. First of all, angle X and 145 degree, these two angles lie on a straight line, that AB is a straight line. AB is a straight line, so these two angles lie on a straight line. AB is a straight line, 145 degree, and angle X lie on a straight line. We easily find angle X by subtracting 145 from 180 degree. Angle X is equal to 180 degree minus 145 degree. Answer is 35 degree. So our topic is finding unknown angles. We find unknown angle by any method. Either we use angle on a straight line method, or we use vertically opposite angle. Now angle X and angle Z, these two are vertically opposite angle. How these two are vertically opposite angle? Let's see. AB and CD are straight lines. AB, I draw again AB and CD. Look at this. AB and CD are straight lines. When two lines intersect each other at one point, then opposite angles are same, and these opposite angles are called vertically opposite angles. So angle X and angle Z are same, and angle X and angle Z are called vertically opposite angle. Angle X is equal to angle Z is equal to 35 degree. You must have to write the reason, vertically opposite angle. Now what we have left? We have left only angle Y. Now see, here we have a box. Box means we have 90 degree angle. We have AB. AB a straight line. We have on AB straight line, we have three angles. Angle Z, angle Y, and 90 degree. We have three angles and these three angles lie on a straight line. Z, angle Z, angle Y and 90 degree. Z, we know that angle Z we have 35 degree. Here we have 90 degree and only angle Y we are going to find out. We have these three angles, angle Y plus 35 degree plus 90 degree. These three angles lie on a straight line, so these are equal to 180 degree. Now we subtract these two angles from 180 degree. 180 degree minus 90 minus 35, we get 55 degree. So angle Y is equal to 55 degree. We find angle Y by taking angles on a straight line. We know that angles on a straight line add up to 180 degree. Now we have question number 3. PQ is a straight line. We have only one straight line here, that is PQ. I redraw this line PQ. Only this line we have a straight line. Remember this. Find angle TOS. TOS. This one angle TOS. This is full angle, blue full angle we have TOS. So we find this angle. Now as we know, in TOS one angle is given, the other is missing. If we look carefully, line PQ is a straight line and on PQ we have two partitions. One we have 129 degree, other we have missing. So first we find the missing angle, angle TOP. Is equal to 180 degree minus 129 degree. We get 51 degree. So it means TOP, this one angle we have 51 degree. If we want to find angle TOS, this one blue angle, so we have to add 51 and 36. Angle TOS is equal to 51 degree plus 36 degree, 87 degree. So this is how we solve finding unknown angles. This is the last question of our textbook, page number 256. Hope you all understand the concept finding unknown angles. Thank you.